So looking at me today, you must have guessed the topic. Can humans evolve wings? That's what's coming up. So first let's see how the birds evolved wings. The earliest known birds had flight feathers on its legs, which helped them to use their legs as wings. The early birds learned to glide and parachute from the trees before achieving full-fledged flight. These birds seem to have been descended from the arboreal parachuters and gliders like the flying squirrel. They were 13 feet across minimum. This doesn't include the other stuff. Birds and bugs don't just use their wings for flying, but they use their entire bodies. Birds, at least the big ones that fly, have hollow bones. The mammals also have hollow bones, but not to a dramatic extent as much as the birds do. A bird's bone has a density of about 0.3 gram per centimeter cube, whereas a human would average 1.5 gram per centimeter cube. Bones are mostly air-filled but reinforced by cross beams known as tubercula, which is a Latin name for small beams. This makes the bones of the large flying birds extremely light. For a human weighing 70 kgs to achieve any type of flight, he or she would require wings with approximately 20 square feet of surface area. Any person seeking to achieve flight will likely seek for hollow bones too, decreasing the body weight, though not much, because the bones represent only 15% of the total body mass. So reducing the bone weight by 80% would only reduce the total body mass by 12%. If you want to climb under your own power rather than relying on thermals or updrafts or jumping off the mountain tops, you will require muscles to flap the wings, but these muscles are heavy. Birds often have about 1/3 of their total body weight in their pectoral muscles. So imagine yourself with a breastbone that sticks out 3 feet and weighs 25 to 30 pounds on each side. The power required to flap the wings enough to raise the body is the major roadblock in giving the humans wings. Birds, bats and pterosaurs have large pectoral muscles which make about 30-35% of their total body mass which powers their wings.
Humans have tried to make wings before. Around 1894, Otto Lilienthal, an aviation pioneer, became famous in Germany for his widely publicized and successful glider flights. He also studied bird flight and conducted some related experiments. He constructed an ornithopter, although its complete development was prevented by his untimely death on the 9th of August 1896 in a glider accident.
Gliders fly, you have to use only your arms or wings to hold your entire body weight above the ground.
Such as in the gymnastic position known as the Maltese cross. The human body is not adapted to this position, and only a few well-muscled gymnasts can hold it for any length of time.
So because the humans are 3 times heavier than a flying animal should be, maybe we'll be able to fly only after we develop bionic muscles of super strength that are lighter and stronger. We could make the humans 2/3 smaller, but smaller humans with large pectoral muscles, they would look less like humans and more like birds. So I'll leave you with a video of the first man-made successful ornithopter. So we'll meet next Thursday, and until next time, thanks for watching.